We'll be going to the green flag right here out of turn number four. Crossville race fans, you've waited all night long. Here we go. Our first feature of the night, the front wheel drives. 15 laps of distance. We come out of turn number four there to the green flag. Katie Rector's going to jump to the front on the start as Jacob Sharp is going to be working the bottom. Ryan Mastin trying to get around. There's two beating and banging coming out of turn number two. We're going to stay green flag as Cody Rector is going to be taking lap number one. Jacob Sharp overdrives it, falls back to third. Todd Duncan going to be working on the number four spot. Then you got a battle going on between Nathan Adams. Chris Morrison for the number five spot is Nathan Adams going to take it. Nathan Adams going to be going to the outside, trying to get to the number three or four spot. Todd Duncan's going to overdrive it. That's going to give an opportunity to the 893 of Nathan Adams to drive to the outside of him down the front straightaway, moving to the number four spot. Cody Rector still leading the way out front as Ryan Mastin working on your leader in turn number four. We're going to be on lap number three. The 717 of Amelia McLean, she's going to be pulling into the infield. Her night comes to an end. Tough luck to the lady driver, but Nathan Adams, he's going to get around Jacob Sharp down in three. Jacob Sharp's going to get a run coming out of turn number four. Who's going to be taking the number three spot at the flag? It's going to be the 893 of Nathan Adams. So Todd Duncan overdrives it one and two. He's trying everything he can do to get around the one of Jacob Sharp, but it's just not happening. As Nathan Adams moves to the number three spot, your leader on lap number five will be Cody Rector. 10 more laps to go. 10 laps remain in the front wheel drive feature race as Cody Rector's led every single one. Followed by the 69 of Ryan Mastin, then the 893 of Nathan Adams, the one of Jacob Sharp, the zero of Todd Duncan. Then you're going to have the 40 of Chris Morrison. Rector is into lap traffic. He gets around two lap cars. He's going to try to put one in between him and Ryan down the front straightaway. Todd Duncan's moved to the number four spot, got around Jacob Sharp. As the 14's going to sign up the racetrack, Charlene Brown in front of the 893, but we're going to stay green flag. Cody Rector taking lap number eight. Ryan Mastin in second. So your top five car is going to start spreading apart. It's Cody Rector starting to pull away from the pack. So it's going to be the 46 Cody Rector, 69 of Ryan Mastin, then that blue A93 of Nathan Adams. Nathan Adams started this race in the number eight spot, moved up all the way to number three. Trying to work on your number two man now. Five more laps remain in the front wheel drive feature race. So right here, we're going to have four laps. Cody Rector still leading the way. He's at lead every single lap. He picked up that heat race win number one. Now he's going to be trying to pick up the feature here at Crossville Speedway for the first race of our big racing for the Ultimate Super Late Model Series Battle of the Bluegrass 4000 to win, which that feature will be coming up momentarily. But right now, Cody Rector putting on the clinic. But Nathan Adams all over the bumper of the 69 of Ryan Mastin as they go down the back straightaway. We're going to cross the flag stand. Cody Rector, Ryan Mastin, Nathan Adams still. But Nathan Adams is going to look for a move. He's got to find a way because he's going to be running out of laps. This time around will be the white flag. If he's going to make a move, he's got to do it now to get to the number two spot because Cody Rector has taken the white flag. Nathan was looking to the inside, but Ryan had slipped up, fell back in front of Nathan. So we're going to come out of turn number four. Cody Rector picking up your win, followed by Ryan Mastin. And then Nathan Adams, Todd Duncan will be your top four cars. But Crossville Speedway makes some noise for the 46 of Cody Rector.
Dwarfs, you are needed in.
The group's going to bunch up down the back straightaway. Dwayne Allen, Jonathan Allen's going to be bringing it to the green flag. When they come out of turn number four, we're going to be going racing in the Dwarf feature race. You guys are watching this on Speedway Video Productions. So, Jonathan Allen's going to be jumping to the outside. He's going to jump to an early race lead, followed by Jonathan Allen. Austin Burton's going to be moving to the number three spot. Rodney Hall falls all the way back to fourth, but he's going to be working the inside of the racetrack, trying the quick railway around Crossville Speedway. Jonathan Allen still out front on lap number one. Dwayne Allen second, Austin Burton third. Then you're going to have the seven of Chris Lefevre in fourth. Rounding out your top five will be the 0-1 of Rodney Hall. Dwayne Allen's going to be looking to the inside of Jonathan Allen down the back straightaway. He's going to be taking the race lead as we go into turn number three. So we're going to come out of four. We've got a new race leader on lap number three. The 21 of Dwayne Allen moves to the lead. That's going to put the 88 of Jonathan Allen in second, Austin Burton in third. So your top five cars starting to fan out a little bit, but we got a battle still going on for that number one spot. Jonathan Allen's trying everything he can do to get around Dwayne Allen as he's going to try to cut down to the bottom. Couldn't make it happen out of turn number two. So we're going to come out of turn number four. Dwayne Allen's going to take lap number five with 10 more laps of racing left here at Crossville Speedway for this Dwarf feature race. They're coming up on a lap car as they come down the front straightaway. That's going to be the 96 of Cody Norris. Dwayne Allen's going to get around him. Jonathan Allen's going to have to go to the high side. Austin Burton's going to drop down to the bottom side. Austin Burton's going to make some room. He's going to try to get around Jonathan Allen down in turn number three. The lap car was a benefit to the 15 of Austin Burton as he goes just sliding into the number two spot, taking it away from Jonathan Allen. Whoa, Jonathan Allen's going to hit Bumbleow in the right rear tire. Slides up the racetrack. We're going to remain green flag as they're trying to get around Curtis Bumbleow. Bumbleow's coming to a slow down in three. We're going to be looking for a caution flag, but we're going to remain green flag. So Austin Burton's going to take advantage of the mishap. He's going to move to the number two spot. Dwayne Allen's going to be out front. Rodney Hall's going to go to the number three spot as Brumbleau's going to come to a slow, it looks like, on the back straightaway. Caution flag will be out. Six laps left in this Dwarf race. They come out of three. The 21 of Dwayne Allen can get on the gas pedal first. We're going to go to the green flag. Right here we go. Race fans, you are watching this on Speedway Video Productions. So they're going to come out of turn number two. Jonathan Allen's going to get around the 22K of Ron Dotson. He's going to look to the top side of the 15 of Austin Burton down into turn number three. Who's going to pull the number three spot as we come down the front straightaway? It's going to be too close to call for me, but it looked like the 15 of Austin Burton's going to take the number three spot on lap number 10. Dwayne Allen's still going to be out front. Rodney Hall in second. Jonathan Allen's working on the number three man. He's going to cross it over, try to go to the bottom side. They get contact going down the front straightaway. Austin Burton's going to drop plumb down to the bottom of the racetrack. As Rodney Hall's going to get a run down the back straightaway on your leader. Austin Burton's going to fall back to the number five spot. So Dwayne Allen's going to take lap number 12, but he's got company down on the inside of the racetrack. That's going to be the 0-1 of Rodney Hall. Austin Burton's going to pull to the inside of the racetrack. His night's going to come to an end. Tough luck to him. We're going to have two laps left. Bullhorns round for Dwayne Allen, Rodney Hall, Jonathan Allen, Ron Dotson, Dylan Hall, then a seven of Curtis Lefevre. So Dwayne Allen's going to come out of turn number four. He's going to look up. Dustin McDaniel with the flag in the hand. The white flag is out. Now we've got a race on our hands. Rodney Hall, if he's going to do it, he better do it down in three and four. He gets a run down the back straightaway. He's going to look for the crossover move coming out of turn number four. He's going to try to drop down to the bottom of the racetrack. We're going to come across a flag stand. Man, a half a car. The wind's going to go to the 21 of Dwayne Allen, followed by the 0-1 of Rodney Hall, the 88 of Jonathan Allen, the 22K of Ron Dotson, then the 1 of Dylan Hall.
Race fans, that concludes the Dwarf feature race. At this time, I'm going to turn it back over to the voice of the Ultimate Super Late Model Series, Mr. Tommy.
That's the one to go. So the one to go sign has been given. We come out of turn number 4. Duke Lowe on the outside, Brady Lee on the inside will be bringing us to the green flag here at Crossville Speedway for the Super Street Stock feature race. You're watching this on Speedway Video Productions. Duke Lowe's going to jump out front away from Brady Lee as we go down the back straightaway. He's going to pull a lead like no other as we go into turns number 3 and 4. Brady Lee's going to work the high side. As Jeff Profit's going to be looking to the inside of the 31, you got two 31s battling out for the number 2 spot. Jeff Profit on the bottom side. He's going to get around Brady Lee coming out of turn number 2. So you've got Duke Lowe out front. Jeff Profit, but Brady Lee's going to drop down to the bottom side. Though the slider on Jeff Profit. He gets on the biters. They don't make any contacts. We're going to stay clean coming down the front straightaway. Brady Lee, Jeff Profit battling out as Scott Brown's trying to work the bottom side of the racetrack. Eric Kinnery's going to pull into the infield. His knot's going to come to an end. 20 laps the distance for this Super Street Stock race as Duke Lowe is starting to leave them quicker than a Hillary email. Jeff Profit in second, Brady Lee third, Scott Brown fourth, Josh Stoglin fifth. Jay Young will be in the sixth spot. That's what you're looking like as of right now with 4 laps complete. We come across the flag stand with 15 more laps to go. Duke Lowe with almost a full straightaway on the number 2 man of Jeff Profit. Then Brady Lee, Scott Brown, Josh Stoglin, Jay Young. They're going to start spreading them out. The closest battle on the racetrack is going to be that 319 and the 31 of Brady Lee. Scott Brown, Brady Lee, that's going to be your closest battle. As the 5 of Duke Lowe is checked plumb out. Lap number 8 is complete. 12 more laps to go. Jeff Profit second, Brady Lee third, Scott Brown fourth, Josh Stoglin fifth, Jay Young sixth. So he's going to come out of turn number 4, look up and see the halfway sign. We're going to be halfway home as Jay Young pulls into the infield. Tough luck to the J7 of Jay Young. Make sure you race fans. Go on Facebook. Click like on Speedway Video Productions. Click like and follow. Also, click like and follow on YouTube as well. So we're here at Crossville Speedway for the Super Street Stock feature race. 11 laps complete, working on number 12 as Duke Lowe has led every single lap. Jeff Profit in second, Brady Lee in third, Scott Brown in fourth, Josh Stoglin fifth. That's how we're lining them up as of right now. The pack has spread apart, but that battle, Scott Brown is trying everything he can do to get around the 31 of Brady Lee. Six more laps remain for tonight's feature race. This is going to be the last one of the night. Had some awesome racing in the front wheel drive. The Dwarfs, the Ultimate Super Late Models. The Crate Late Models now our final feature of the night. The Super Street Stock as Duke Lowe is going to take lap 15 with 5 more to go. Don't forget we will be back next Friday night for the ASCS Lucas Oil Sprint Cars right here at Crossville Speedway. Going to be an awesome show, so make sure you're making plans to come out next Friday night. So we're ticking the laps off quickly here with Duke Lowe going to be taking lap number 17. 3 more to go. He picked up the feature win last weekend, trying to make it 2 in a row. Two more to go. Bullhorns out. The red and black number five. The 31 of Jeff Prophet. Brady Lee, Scott Brown. White flag in the air. It's going to go to Duclos. Scott Brown's working on the 31 of Brady Lee. He's looking to the bottom side as we come out of turn number four down the front straightaway. White flag in the air for them, but we come out of turn number four. Checkered flag in the air for the five of Duclos, picking up feature win number two in a row. But let's see. Brady Lee's going to go plumb down to the bottom side. Coming out of four, it's going to be Brady Lee second. Third, Brady Lee third. Scott Brown fourth.